Hi, I'm Janessa.
I'm Trevor.
And today we're going to show you how to update your cache with Apollo Client. So here we have an existing, fairly simple to-do app that's hooked up to a GraphQL server. And in our app, you'll see we're already listing out our to-do items, which is from our list to-dos query. We already have a few components set up. We have this to-do form, which fires a mutation when you fill out the input to create a new item in our to-do list. We have a toggle completion checkmark component that fires a different mutation to mark an item as complete or incomplete. And then we have a delete button that fires yet another mutation to remove a to-do item from our app.
When we toggle the completed status of an item in our to-do list, those changes are reflected in our app immediately. And that's because Apollo's cache knows about those items and it's able to update them automatically based on the response of the mutation. But when we create a new to-do item or delete an existing one, the cache doesn't know how to handle those mutation responses and the app doesn't get updated until the page gets refreshed.
So one solution to updating our to-do items in our app without having to manually refresh the page every time is to use an option on our use mutation hook called refetchQueries. And what this option lets us do is to specify the queries that we want to be refetched as soon as our mutation is finished. So in this case, since the to-do list to-dos items is what's rendering on our app, that's the query we want to be refetched. And so similarly, we want to go over to our delete button so that every time we delete an item, that query gets refetched as well.
We can now create new to-dos or delete existing ones, and our app gets updated automatically by refetching our list to-dos query. However, this comes with one downside, and that's that for every add and delete mutation we make, we also fire off an additional GraphQL query. And depending on the amount of time that query takes or the size of its response payload, it could add a lot of extra overhead to our app and potentially slow it down.
So how do we update our cache but avoid having to make that extra GraphQL request? Well, instead of using this refetch queries option on our use mutation hook, we can use a different option called update. And this update option is a function that gives us access to the existing cache as well as the data that comes back from our mutation. This will allow us to manually update the cache but avoid having to make that extra GraphQL request.
In our update function, we'll first want to grab the current state of our list to-dos query. We can do this using cache.readQuery and passing list to-dos as the query option. Next, we'll call cache.writeQuery and update the data associated with this list to-dos query. We're going to spread in the existing state and prepend the data coming back from the mutation add to-do. That should do it for our to-do form. Now on to the delete button. We will update the refetch queries to this new update function. Once again, grab the current state of list to-dos. And finally, write query to update the data associated with list to-dos. This time, mapping over the current state and filtering out any to-dos whose IDs match the ID of the to-do that was just deleted.
So now we've replaced the refetch queries option with an update function. Our app functionality remains. We can still mark items as complete or incomplete. We can add a new to-do item, and we can still delete them. Our app works perfectly, and we've avoided an extra network request.
Woohoo! Woo! Way to go! All right.